our understanding of the universe is very limited. The inability to understand the operation or the working of UFOs underline this very well. UFOs can just appear before eyes and they can just disappear into the thin air. Without making any exhaust or sound, they can just hover in the air. They can take 90 degree angle turn even if they are moving at a very high speed. They don't make any sonic boom even if they are moving at supersonic speeds. They simply don't bother about the gravity, inertia or the friction of the atmospheric air. These kind of behaviors of UFOs are making us very confused and inferior. This led me to consider alternative explanations for all phenomena in the physical world. I think that there are serious issues with the present-day understanding about the universe and the present-day theories and concepts, especially in physics. In my opinion, this is why a UFO still remains as UFO. I have developed a different explanation for light. This explanation also helped me to think about the possibility of a wave which can travel faster than light speed. Probably, advanced extraterrestrial civilizations in the universe are utilizing this kind of waves for the communication between interstellar distances. In the previous video, we saw that the magnetic lines of a magnet are not imaginary, but they are real. And also, like a magnet, a charged particle like electron has its own tiny magnetic field around it. We also saw that the speed of light is the speed of the propagation of magnetic lines in space, and light is the modulation of waves on these propagating magnetic lines. Please watch my previous video, which provides a detailed explanation for light. I think that the speed of the propagation of the magnetic lines of an electron may be much greater than the speed of the propagation of a normal magnetic line. That is the speed of light. Therefore, a modulation on these tiny magnetic lines can travel much faster than the speed of light. Electric activities in the brain generates a magnetic field around the brain, and thought process in the brain generates vibrations in this magnetic field. This is the vibrations we record with EEG machines as brain waves. I think that these vibrations can also make disturbances in the tiny magnetic lines of the electrons that in the brain, and these vibrations can create a kind of signals, and these signals are radiated to space. Probably this is how a brain generates or transmits telepathic signals. On the other hand, in the reverse process, when such a signal interacts with the magnetic fields of the electrons that in a receiver brain, that receiver brain can detect the signal and translate into the original thought. I think that an instrument with extreme sensitivity to fluctuating magnetic fields can possibly pick up this kind of signals. Also, such an instrument can possibly generate, transmit this kind of signals. Here I suggest researchers to consider this possibility very seriously. I think that we may be able to pick up signals from extraterrestrial civilizations with this kind of technology. This is the time to switch our search for extraterrestrial radio signals to faster than light signals. It is reasonable to think that very advanced extraterrestrial civilizations in the universe are not depend on radio signals or light signals for the communication between interstellar distances. Most probably, they have already developed faster than light technology for the communication between very long distances.